He left his native Ireland, his fortune for to find. And he sailed across to America, beyond the ocean wide. As a soldier he proved bold and true, stood tall among the rest. And his name was Patrick Claiborne, the Stonewall of the West. He made his home in Arkansas until 1861. He swore allegiance to the South when the conflict had begun. And the fury that awaited him he scarcely could have guessed. But Claiborne was a mighty man, the Stonewall of the West. Well, he found himself in Tennessee in 1864. The Confederate army was nearly spent and couldn't stand much more. And General Hood, only God knows why, he put them to the test. Well, if we're to die, let us die like men, said the Stonewall of the West. 'Twas on that sad November day when Claiborne met his fate. The rebels were outnumbered and the field they could not take. As he led his men through a hail of fire, a bullet pierced his breast. And Ireland called home the soul of the Stonewall of the West. Many's the brave man died that day on the bloody Franklin ground. The smell of death hung in the air and the bodies lay all around. Six southern generals lost their lives, but none so sorely missed as Claiborne, the pride of Erin, the Stonewall of the West. As Claiborne, the pride of Erin, and the Stonewall of the West.